show.
All right, we're going to get started. Thanks everyone for coming. Thank you very much. Always happy when people show up. And we'll get straight into it. My name's Spaceman. We've got Nick on the drums, my good friend MJ on the bass. Tonight we're going to present to you Spaceman Africa the Musical. Some weird and wonderful songs about my time on this planet. Starting with a song about the fun and games I had in New Orleans many years ago. It's called New Orleans Merry-Go-Round. Tonight, They've made an exception because normally they only have gigs on Friday and Saturday, but such was the demand to see us. They've allowed us to play this evening. So I encourage you to get some coffees, teas, or muffins.
Muffins! Similar to puffins, isn't it? Puffins, yes. Still muffins.
True. And penguins.
Penguins sit on.
We have the best backdrop in the world. Penguin book.
Sorry. Alright, I'll
put it away. Matthew, does it still sound alright up the back? Yeah, or has it improved somewhat?
Yeah, maybe a little bit more on the vocal.
Alright. MJ, would you mind just moving channel 4 up a fraction? The fourth?
Channel 4.
Spaceman.
Basically, if you hold that there, it's going to make an omnidirectional like that. So it's going to feed back.
So, you have our permission to laugh and cheer and clap, stamp your feet, cry. Is that what you're planning on doing? And, some of the songs are deliberately funny, so feel free to laugh. Don't think it's going to be rude to laugh. It's all right. Feel free to heckle. No, don't heckle. I'm a bit sensitive. But
heckle
Nick,
me.
Nick loves it.
Heckle my drum kit. This is marvelous, isn't it?
I like the stand.
Thank you, Hannah. This drum kit is being fashioned tonight from a rug. And thanks very much to Simon and his chairs. Thank you, Jenny, as well, for your chairs and your part in your taking the chairs. And yes, we're selling the drum kit while we're playing, just for the hour and 10 minutes. So if you want to buy the drum kit as it is, it doesn't come with the chairs. It comes as it does.
How much?
Does the player come with it? Is that included?
You can hire me.
Right.
You hire me for that.
How
for
much?
The time.
Where do you want to start the bidding?
$50. $50.
That's not sold.
Oh, wow. How long? Woo! You opened that.
Well, we're going to get paid a little bit tonight.
Just one of you. Not necessarily.
Yeah, just
for
one
singing.
Of us.
We are served as the spaceman.
Nick's going to go home now that he's made his money.
Yes.
The other thing I recommend is if you heckle MJ, do it at your own risk. Cause if you upset her, she'll kick your ass.
I will. Introducing.
You think I'm joking.
Is that for sale? The spotted polka dots.
It comes with the drum kit.
It's a good way of adding to it. All right.
No, man, you think I'm joking? I've seen it. MJ was in a covers band called Jack's 11.
I know, you'll remember.
Jack's 11.
And this was at the Royal in Queanbeyan. And the band were in the corner, there was no elevated stage at all, and they were playing covers, so the crowd knew the songs, and sometimes people would get up and use MJ's mic to sing along in the chorus. But on this night, you're quite cramped for room, I think, and this guy stood in between you and your mic, and you had no room, and you sort of let it go for one song, but when he came up for the second, MJ just grabbed the mic off him, elbowed him in the ribs, and he got the message you left.
Yes.
Yeah.
So
do anything you want. Laugh, clap, cheer, but don't go near MJ's mic. She won't be. She might elbow you in the ribs.
Very pointy.
And the boots. All right, so people who don't know the story about my name, many years ago I got quite drunk and changed my name to Spaceman Africa.
Quite depot?
Yes.
All the way.
My friend and I, we were having a conversation how easy it is to get a depot. So we thought we'd do it. And he changed his name to Crazy Horse Invincible. And if you ever think of changing your name, I recommend it. It's very entertaining. For example, I won a Name of the Year competition in 2008. I beat Fonda Dix in the final. I based my name on a bracelet I had from South Africa. It was written S Africa. And Spaceman used to be a nickname, starts with S, so I chose Spaceman Africa. And what else has happened? In 2004, Crazy Horse and I booked flights to Eastern Europe. And the story went viral because the airline saw Crazy Horse's name on the passenger list, thought he was up to some sort of fraud, and he had to go into the airport to prove his ID. But they didn't question my name. But I haven't got off scot-free with airports. I'm always chosen for the random bag search. They always think I'm smuggling drugs. And then like 2 years ago, man, Qantas phoned the police on me. I did the self-check-in, so I didn't deal with any of the staff.
Yeah.
And then I'm at the boarding gate, and I get paged, could passenger Spaceman Africa come to boarding gate 17?
Seriously, you never told me as well.
And then, as I get up, and I'm walking towards the gate, two cops show up, and they're like, do you have ID? And I'm like, oh, is that what this is about? And then I'm like, what do you want? Passport, driver's license, Medicare card, credit card. And then they went, oh, we just have to make sure we get some crazies.
Horses that out.
Yes. And often they'll say, what, Africa's your last name? What, Africa is in the country? And I say, no, Africa's not a country, it's a continent.
And look around, see, it's a lovely kit tonight, isn't it? It's really going, being sold for the next 50 minutes. If you can think of a lovely price, well, we can talk later.
I think you can only offer a pretty decent price for that. No offense.
I'll take it, my lady.
This isn't his A-grade drum kit, is it? No, he's got others. You should put a sticker on there saying, my other drum kit is a pearl.
And it's enormous.
Yeah. And it doesn't need no stinking chairs. Alright, so this song's called Who is Spaceman Africa? If you listen carefully, you'll hear what my name was before I changed it. And
Greg.
At the end, I list
Greg.
Some of my aliases. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4. It was for the man who changed his name. His name went far and broad and fame. People online and a ticking time, and his life was never the same. Crazy horse, they had no remorse, no Smoking, but the first time because I just made this shit up. Never to be used again. Depends on the reaction. And so the first time the gas bottle caught a light and it was inside the van. I panicked, picked it up, put it outside. And it fell over and rolled under the van. So I nearly shit myself. And then I had to put the van in neutral, move it out of the way. And then like a hippie came up and told us off. And then
that was me.
We tried to find water. We couldn't find water. And I had this mobile phone, but I didn't know how to use it, so I'm asking people, can they phone the fire brigade?
You were stoned.
Well, I didn't... No, I don't do drugs. And so that ended up with two big fire trucks saving the day. And then a few weeks later, the radio caught on fire.
Oh, it's an accident song.
The live wires touched metal and there was smoke everywhere. And we panicked because in Hollywood, cars blow up all the time, but thankfully we weren't in Hollywood. This is called It's on Fire. We need total silence because this song's very, very quiet. First time, but when they come the second time, it's like, yes. And it will be available again tonight. If you've already bought it, feel free to buy it again. If you haven't already bought it, feel free to buy it for the first time. Album and a book with all the stories behind the songs. So all the stories I'm telling you tonight, but in extended form, written form, funny form.
Sorry, man, I'm not. I can't help but eat
this. All right, you eat it, and I'll read the blurb on the back of this. Because All right, so At the age of 22, Spaceman Africa left his hometown of Canberra in Australia to travel the world. First stop, London. Over the following 20 years, Spaceman has had numerous funny experiences and some unfortunate mishaps that only now, with the passing of time, can he look back and laugh.
Tragic.
Here is Spaceman Africa. What does that say? Here Spaceman shares 12 comical stories from his time abroad and at home. From being propositioned whilst hitchhiking in Germany, to writing postcards to random strangers from the Dublin phone book, to inventing a new sport in Peru. Spaceman Africa the Musical contains engaging and amusing tales and answers the question we're all dying to know: how did he get his name? For each song Spaceman has composed, start again. For each story, Spaceman has composed and recorded a song, the result of which is the album Africa as in the Continent.
Thank you, man. You gave me my breathing space for my prawns.
Yes.
They're delicious.
See, they think I was trying to sell the book, but I was just giving you time to eat.
I know, man. I know it wasn't a plug. No, I'm grateful as always.
I was just reading out loud. Now I've lost my pick. Roadie. This song is about a hitchhiking experience in Germany, which was going really well until the guy pulled out a pornographic magazine, started touching himself, and propositioned me.
Oh. And you're still single to this day.
This song is called Horny German Truck Driver. Featuring MJ on the bass.
Oh, wow.
I found myself hitchhiking on the road in Germany. I had me a sign explaining my next destiny. Just when I thought a ride wasn't meant to be, along came a trucker who stopped to pick up me. And I knew you too, I'll have my way with you. I said, I'm from this land, so I don't understand why you don't use your hand. Cause he's a horny German truck driver. He wants to be a sex favor. Gets lonely on the road. He wants my help to shoot him low. Which I was keen to read. The naked women in the book, they were a sight to see. The driver got excited, I could see his pink undies. The next thing I knew, he was flirting there with me. I do you too, can I do you too? I'll have my way with you. I said, I'm on this plan, so I don't understand why you don't use your hand. Who wants to pay him or me? I said, I know.
alive. Yeah, he's alive.
That's the end of the story.
The poor guy, he was just a normal guy and he was just horny and he thought he'd politely ask if I was interested. I said no. And
you got out, that's it.
So the song goes big when you know who he is.
That's the end. That's the end of the story. That's the end.
You didn't even get a name, did you?
No.
Phone number. Not even his license plate. I was really scared. And I didn't want to turn him down, so I pretended I didn't understand because conversation was in German. And then I thought, we could go on like this forever. So eventually I thought, I'll say no. And I sort of braced myself for his reaction. And he did surprise me with his reaction.
Oh, sorry.
He became all normal. And he said, all right, yes, so what are you just studying in German? Or are you backpacking? What are you up to? And I said, well, I'm getting off at the next stop. And when I mean getting off, I mean... All right, speaking of getting off...
Yeah, man.
Well, since for my nephew's first Christmas, he was 7 months old. I thought, oh God, I better buy him a Christmas present. But what am I going to buy? I don't know. Cuddly soft toy seems a bit stereotypical, a bit predictable. So I couldn't find anything. And then as the day loomed, I thought, I'd better get something. So I did buy a cuddly toy bear. But the cuddly toy bear I bought was dressed in bondage clothing. And had leather undies, leather straps, had the ball in the mouth. And was called Bondage Bob. And it went down a treat at Christmas. The parents were there, the in-laws were there.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yes. Well, thankfully, the grandparents didn't even understand what it was. And thankfully, the child didn't either. This song's called Bondage Bob. The bear came with a little poem, and you can hear that in the bridge of this song, which is called Bondage Bob. It's Christmas 2001, the first Christmas for Neville's son. I bought a gift for baby John, a toy and gift for a boy so young. But my present to John was the best part on, surprise to all,
designed to start.
Soft toy bear, cuddly and fun.
And the fun had just begun. The next hot crawl, Bondage Bob, from the novelty shop. Bondage Bob, he wears a leather jaw. Bondage Bob, from the novelty shop.
You see, I bought a bed. Bondage wear with leather straps and underwear. The parents were there, but they didn't care. The grandparents, well, they were unaware. Bob the bear, super debonair. He's loved for handcuffs, a real bugbear. You can't take him anywhere. Bondage Bob, the next top brawl. Bondage Bob, from the multi shop. I'll wear my leather now, what the weather, we've
Bob, you ain't never talk. Bondage Bob, from a novelty shop.
Yes, indeed.
Really is marvellous. It's everything you need in the kit. 3,000 yen.
I don't need a kit.
That's alright.
Alright, next song. It's called Mel and Junior Stand. This is about me and a good friend. Been mates for 30 years. We've travelled the world. Lots of funny stories. And he's going to come up and introduce it. He's going to tell this story. Please welcome Brian to the microphone.
Can we heckle Brian?
Yes.
So
I just broke the microphone stand.
Space said we've known each other for 30 years. We've gone to school together. We traveled
together.
Are you
that old?
Pardon?
Are you that old?
I was really, really young. Thank you. What he didn't tell you about his name was that when they decided to do it, he called into work dead. So he's the only bloke I know that rang up, his crazy horse rang up where they were both working in London because they didn't want to go back to work because they're having such a great time in Dublin, that his mate rang up and said, oh, I'm really sorry, but previous name, he's dead. Like, can you please send me his outstanding pay and I'll arrange it with his estate and look after everything. And then they went, oh my God, that's so bad. Oh yeah, we'll take care of it. Hung up and they went back to drinking and changed their name. So he's the only person I've ever known that called into work dead. But, as much as we've all thought about him. So to introduce this song, we went to school together. We used to catch the bus for many years together. After school, we used to play football. We're big football fans. We used to support the Balmain, we still do support the Balmain Tigers. We gave ourselves nicknames based on our favourite players. So I was Junior and Space was Mel, based on a player. So we used to play at this oval in Curtin, and they had a toilet block up on one side of it. And we used to go up there after the game and sit up there, and we used to call it the Mel and Junior Stand after the two of us. We were kids. Anyway, one night we all got back together, like we were all studying and off doing things after school. We had a big night, all came home, didn't want to finish the night, so I snuck into my parents' place and got whatever booze I could, and we went back down the oval and continued drinking. Space had the idea, I've always wanted to spray paint the toilet block. I've always wanted to do that. So I said, great. So our other mate, Derek, who was studying to become a copper, said, I have no part of this, so he stood over one side of the oval. I was not wanting to let Space down, but also not wanting to get caught, so I stood in the middle of the oval. Space went and grabbed...
In the white.
Space went and got a can of black spray paint. Anyway, off he went, 2 o'clock in the morning, went to spray paint the Mel and Junior Stand on the toilet block. Anyway, came back, Derek, myself, and he got together, and we looked up, and his entire face was covered in black spray paint. And we asked him what had happened. You can tell slightly better. As he was going over there, it was dark. He was fumbling with the can of spray paint. And as he went to do it, he had the nozzle facing the wrong way. So it sprayed black spray paint all over his face. Not content with that, when he eventually picked up the spray can to do it properly, he went to do it, and again, he sprayed his face with black spray paint. So we all had a good laugh. We were getting hungry. We went down to the Coles to buy something to eat. I said, you can't come into Coles with black spray paint all over your face. So off he went to the toilet, washed himself up, came back and said, you can't take that spray can in with you. So, no. So he went over to put it in the bushes. As he pushed it down into the bushes, the spray paint sprayed up all over him again. And thus was born the song, The Mel and Junior Stand. T-shirts available for sale down the back.
You can also buy these prawns.
This song has some audience participation as well. can all join in and show off your vocal skills.
Let's do it, people. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah.
Come on!
Woo.
Yeah!
You, me, and MJ, supporting space. We're intimate here, but we are mighty. We can do this for space. Alright. Come on! Yeah!
It's gonna be easy, don't worry. You just need to know two words. The first one is paint, and the second one is also paint. So if you can remember those two words, you'll be okay. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Nick just about recording songs, and he said I could use his studio if ever I wanted to record some songs. So I said, oh yeah, why not? I thought I might as well record an album, might as well record with drums and bass, and so I recorded an album. I thought I might as well play them live and form a band, and I thought I might as well invite you all along, and here we are. So thanks very much, Nick.
My pleasure, man. Thank you, all of you. Thank you, MJ. Thanks,
thanks a
lot.
Thanks to Nick and MJ for being part of the band.
Yeah. Thank you, man. Woo. Thank you for the stories.
The other big contributor was my friend Kieran, who did a lot of the awesome artwork you'll find in the book. And he thankfully made it here tonight, so thank you.
Yeah.
Make sure you have a look before you leave tonight. There's some really clever comical artwork, such as on Brian's t-shirt.
All right.
Do it, Brian.
The opposite of a strip club. Put it on, put it on.
First time.
So, speaking of Brian.
This one's for you, Caroline. This one's for you. I'm not even allowed to dedicate them, but I'm dedicating.
Oh, thank you.
Because this song's about a man called Brian Oliver who...
Oh, it's in Dublin. Yeah, thank you.
I had some postcards. Yeah. I didn't know who to write to. So I grabbed the phone book from behind the bar.
Which I'm probably related to him. We're all inbred.
Well, you might even get a mention in this song. And so we chose him randomly out of the phone book and we started sending him postcards. Crazy Horse and I, we were travelling a lot at the time and we sent this guy postcards from all around the world. The beauty of it was that we never gave our last names or gave a return address and we pretended we were like long lost mates and that we'd been mates for years. And
now I'm thinking it's a bit cruel.
Well,
but that's okay.
Like after 3 months after we started,
anyway,
Crazy Horse rang up pretending to sell insurance and we sort of gathered he was in his 50s or 60s and when we realised he wasn't an old senile man, we thought game on and we sent him postcards for the next 3 years.
Right.
Until eventually I met him.
Did you get a laugh out of it? No.
Did I get what?
Did you get a laugh out of it?
Myself?
No.
Brian, I thought
it was hilarious.
No. I'm sure you thought it was hilarious.
This song is called Brian Oliver. It's a tongue-in-cheek dig at Brian for never writing back, but of course he couldn't because
he didn't have an address for you.
Exactly.
Yeah. Which makes you look like a bit of a bastard, really.
That's my middle name. Spaceman, Bastard Africa. Thomas Foley and then another one called
Wait, guys, you might
Andrew
just tell me, like, you might just be telling the story of one of my brothers here or something, you know.
Well, even the better for you to listen. Anyway, I have another funny story, but let's just do this.
She's a song right. While you're still alive.
One, two, three, four. Brian Oliver, why don't you mind? Tell about me that you hold you right. Brian Oliver, hey man, what for? Don't forget now I know where you live. Hey,
our share of some pretty good crap. Calm now, travel's well taken. One or two postcards and now the door. Right, not a girl, why don't you mind? Something about me that you don't need. Right, not a girl, ain't that much good? Don't forget now I know where you live. You've always been welcome to join us. Sweet Derrière. It's about painful experience my backside had when I accidentally swallowed petrol. I was in Leicester Square and there was some fire-breathing display going on and my friend dared me to have a go. So I went up, put the fuel in my mouth. I didn't know you're not meant to swallow it. I put the flame to my mouth, opened my mouth and nothing happened. So I had another guy, I said, give me that, and I put it in. I didn't swallow, put the flame to my mouth, and boom, big fireball. I was like, yes, I did it. And then we went off, and I developed this really sore throat, much like I have now. And then, but the next day, I had the most painful arse, as like the gas made its way through the system. I could hardly walk. It was like I had razor blades up my bum. It was, and I remember having to walk down Kensington High Street, going to the bank, and it was so bad. And this song is called Sweet Derrière.
Oh, I reckon you deserve it. Come on, give it love.
Good.
One, two, three, four.
Are you doing that, man, right?
I
just testing
us. Are you okay, Dave?
Yeah,
you
alright?
Yeah.
I'm okay,
you're okay. No, in a nice way.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's a nice thing to ask somebody if they're okay.
Oh, no, I'm joking.
Alright, I got it now.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. You know, is everyone okay?
Everyone all right?
I think you were having it.
Just turn to the person next to you, you know, give them a good look in the eyes.
Yeah.
They might be a loved one, they may not be.
Yeah.
They may become a loved one.
We love you.
Get up and stretch your legs.
No, wait, wait, wait. No, wait. we're loving this.
You're both good again. Everyone good again.
We're loving it.
1, 2, 3, 4. A word of advice: when fire breathes, and be sure not to swallow fuel. What happened to me could happen to you. Oh man, I was such a fool.
One, two, three.
it up and you grow. Rub it up, rub it rough. I tell you folks, I can't have been enough. It's okay, dark in the rough. Easy now that I've been banned from touching cats in my homeland. But I say it's a cop and I thought it was a hole. And I say it's a cop and I thought it was a hole. I swear I'm not gay, what a shock. Travels. I'll just read the back. It's pretty much what Brian said. I was in Dublin, faked my death, changed my name, had some funny adventures. Buy the book.
Are you absolutely hang on a second. Are you messing?
Are you
absolutely serious? Like.
Memoir.
You're fucking joking, like.
Grab your own copy up the back after the show. I'll be willing to sign it.
Jesus,
no,
that's fucking unbelievable. Like, yeah, how much is that?
Well, you, on its own, it's $20, but if you buy other stuff, it works out to be cheaper.
Right. I got paid today. You're lucky. I actually got paid today.
Yes.
You're lucky.
We should play on payday.
Quite a collection, Karen.
I got paid today. You're lucky.
We accept cash and
pay paydays. Play paydays.
While we're having this little break, I'd like to thank my bandmates tonight for playing.
Pleasure, Space.
Nick. These two are actually in, this is a side project for them. They're in bigger and better bands.
You can sort of
we'll
tell
give them
that.
A bit of a plug. So Filthy Darlings, which is Nick's main band. They're playing at the Phoenix this Friday, for example.
Come on down, guys.
Check them out on all the socials. The Filthy Darlings.
Thank you, my man.
And MJ's band, main band, Urban Drover. A country rock covers band.
Yes. She's important to me.
And normally playing at Rose Cottage.
Yes, with the Vikings.
Tavern on Vikings this weekend. All right. I won't be there, but I recommend you. So thanks, guys. So, speaking of other bands,
MJ.
We're going to do a cover of another band. Any Flight of the Conchord fans amongst us?
Yeah, love. When I came back, I came to Australia. Now I know Australia, I know they're New Zealand, right? I know Flight of the Conchord. Yeah, they're New Zealand. Before I came to Australia, like 2 years before, I was watching them. I thought it was the funniest thing I ever saw. And like, absolutely hilarious.
Nice. This song is called Feeling.
Oh. I know. Sorry.
Sing along.
No, I absolutely love it.
Lauren,
you
can sing
when you're there.
Mocktail. And now once again, you guys can get involved
at the end there's an opportunity where we can pretend we're in a stadium rock show and we just fist pump.
Unite.
And become a chorus.
That's right.
And we can hail the mocktail. You don't know what is a mocktail? A cocktail without alcohol. Best drink. Actually, that's addressed in the song, actually, the reaction that people get when I mention mocktail. All
right.
Yeah, ready?
1, 2, 3.
I'm a teacher. Bye. love this. Everyone join in. It's just very funny having a bar full of people going, hey, I'm not.
Isn't it? That the bug is out of business, doesn't it?
Well, they probably don't serve mocktails. All right, well, that's the end of the show, unless someone wants one more.
Oh, one more! Have you got one you just learned?
Just for you, Bill. All right, we've got one more. This one is about how I offended the entire Hamburg cricket team. I met the captain coach on the train. He was from Pakistan and we got chatting about cricket. He invited me to come along to a training session. And I mean, Germans don't know about cricket, so the whole team was full of expats from the subcontinent where cricket's a religion. And I was in the outfield fielding and I got so bored I grabbed a chair and just sat in the outfield on a chair and really offended the other players. They said I had no respect for the game. The thing is, I didn't have my glasses, I didn't have contact lenses, so I didn't even see when the ball was coming towards me anyway. I'd go flying past before I even knew what was going on. So I thought, blow this, I'm gonna sit in a chair. And then, I mean, I wasn't ball tampering. I mean, I don't know what the problem was. But this song is called I Don't Like Cricket. You might recognize the tune. We may not even have to ask to sing along before we start.
I don't like cricket style. Oh no, set. I say I don't like the kids' style. Oh no, it's a bit. Yeah, I don't like the kids' style. Oh no, it's so shit. Coming. Thank you, Simon and Jenny, for having us this evening. Thank you very much. Thank you, Lauren, for coming. Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Kieran. Thanks very much for your help. Thanks, Brian, for your help coordinating this evening.
With
Spaceman. I can't even see who's at the back. Thanks very much for coming along. Thank you, Neville, my stage manager.
Go, Neville.
Go, Neville. Go, Neville. And come up and say hello, I'll be up the back at the table. Thank you. Good night.
We're still recording, man.
No, I do it on my computer. No, I need that.
Thanks, Bill. Thanks for coming. Thank you. What's that?
Is there enough button?
I had a great time. All my hustle. You're an amazing bass player. You're a fucking gorgeous bass player. Jesus, you've got all the riffs. You're a fucking fabulous.
You've got all the facial expressions.
You're like
the attitude.
You're totally funky. You're amazing. You're just,
you make them credit.
Fabulous.
Oh, so I guess.
You actually do. You're fabulous. Sorry, I don't mean to sound patronizing, like, you know, just because you're a girl. No, you're absolutely fantastic. No, you're fabulous. I'm a musician myself, so.
She's fabulous.
I'm not.
She's her own fabulous.
Carolyn McNicholas, look at her on the internet. She's fabulous. No, but like, seriously, your bass playing was like, you knocked me out.
The bomb. You were. You had it. Got it. The present.
Yeah.
God.
She was amazing. No, but honestly,
I do know you, man.
No, but
this
is happening. But honestly,
someone's pumping me up.
Oh, but yeah, but I hope, yeah, but.
Give us your card. Come back to our place.
Have you got a card?
Good. Can you give it to her?
It's okay, don't worry.
Just write on the script.
We'll find you. We'll
track it out.
The thing is, we have the connection. Spaceman.
Yes. Networking.
Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking. Networking
girl and the waitress are going to follow you now. I'm sorry. I know. Make scenes in the front row for you.
M. James, I'm so sorry. I know. It seems like...
Why are you sorry?
I talk to you about your girl.
You're so cute, Caroline. How can you? You've got nothing to be sorry for. It's funny to write sideways. You can write and you can do it. You can do it diagonal. I don't know why you need it.
You've got life footage.
You're not trying to do it.
I think it's because it's
business card. Thank you. Ask your
partner to do it. Life footage.
I'm going out now.
Okay, so life footage. I'm going to try to do this. No, we're not.
You might as well. I mean, there's nothing else.
We're just trying to shape. Sure.
We need the...
I'm sorry.
I don't want to go...
The top three.
Do you have cash or?